Hello guys, in this tutorial we'll learn how to add support for multiple languages in your game. That will include changing text and sprites. Note that this is part 1 in which we learn the fundamentals of the localization package. Subscribe and turn on notifications so you don't miss part 2 in which we explore more details of the package. The first thing you need to follow this tutorial is to have Unity version 2021.2 or higher. To start, go to the package manager. Select Unity Registry, search for the localization package and install it. Next, go to the project settings and select localization. As you can see, we don't have any localization settings, so let's create one. I will create a new folder just to keep the project organized. The next step is to choose what languages you need. Unity syntax for language is local. So click on the local generator and add languages. For example, I will choose English, Spanish and French. Now let's generate locales. Again, I will create a new folder called locales. Now let's choose a default language. Expand specific locale selector. This will be a default language for the game. I will choose English. It's good to match this project language with the default language, so set project local identifier to English. Great, we can close settings. Now I will show you how to change the text. First, go to Window, Asset Management, Localization Tables, select New Table Collection. As you can see, we can create string and asset table collections. We need to control text, which means we need a string table collection. I will call it string example table. Click on the create button to create the table. Then you create a key. I will call it example key. The key will hold a reference to the text you write for different languages. For example, the English text will be Hello YouTube, the French Bonjour YouTube and Spanish Hola YouTube. Of course, you can create as many keys as you want with different text. Then click on the button above the language. You want to make sure that these preloading options are selected. Great. Here I have simple text mesh pro text. We can delete the default text. Then add the localization string event component to the text. Make sure it's a string event because we change strings. So for the string reference, choose the table and key that we made before. Notice that now you can see the text for different languages. Then we need to tell Unity which text to control. Add update string event. We use the text mesh pro text and we need to pass the string. So use text mesh pro and under dynamic string choose text. Let's try it. The default language is English, as you can see. Notice that you have one drop down menu in the upper right corner. This is visible only in Unity, it will not be in the game, but you can change the language and see how the game will look. Let's change it and the text should also change. Nice. Now let's see how we can change languages in the game using buttons. We need to create one script, I will call it local selector. First we need to include the localization settings namespace. Then it's important to use the IE numerator function. I call it setLocal and it takes one int parameter local ID. First, make sure that localization is loaded and ready to use. Then we select local from available locales using local ID. The ID is the number of the locale in the project settings. In this case, English ID will be 0, French 1, Spanish 2, and so on. Now let's create a function for buttons. Make it public void and also it needs to take one int parameter. This function will start coroutine that we created. Of course, paste the local ID to the function. Just to make sure that the coroutine is not called more than once, I'll create one bool variable. For example, if the button is pressed fast many times, you can get multiple calls. With this simple method, we eliminate that possibility. Great, this is all we need to code. In Unity, create an empty game object, Localization Manager. Add the local selector script. Select the button and add the onClick event. Drag the Localization Manager object. Choose the local selector script. We need the change local function. Now we need to pass the ID. For English, the ID is 0. Now let's do this for the other two buttons. For French, the ID is 1. For Spanish, the ID is 2. Great, let's try it. As you can see, we can change the language. Of course, to remember what language the player has chosen, you would need to save the local ID number and load the local at the start. This is a simple example of using player prefs with saving and loading locales. When you choose a locale, save the ID and in the start just call the function with the ID you saved. Now let's see how to change sprites. I will quickly create UI image and change the position and shape. Then add the localize sprite event, make sure it's sprite event. Then we can click on the create table button. This time we need asset table collection. Again, we have the table, you can add the key and choose the sprite for every language. I will show you another way how to do it. Close this. Select the flag image. Choose the asset table that we made. Then click on the add table entry button to add the key. It will be the flag key. Now select the sprites for each language. If you now open the table, you will see the same settings. Then add the update asset event. For the object, use the image. We need to update the sprite of our image. That's it. Let's try it. Nice. But we are not done yet. We need to do one more thing to use localization in the build. Go to Window, Asset Management, Addressables, and select Groups. You need to go to the Build button. Here you need to create a new build. If you already have it, you can do the update. If you have any problems, then you can choose to clean the build and create a new one. Let's create a new build. Also, if you have any errors because this localization package is new, you can go to the Analyze window. You can select the rules and click on the Analyze button. If you find any errors, try to fix them with the Fix Selected Rules button. And now you know the fundamentals of the localization package. Thank you and see you in the second part.